We are on chapter 14, which covers psychological disorders. They are also referred to as mental disorders, psychiatric disorders, or mental illness, and they refer to an illness of the mind. As you may remember, in class, we made a distinction between a psychological disorder and the everyday ups and downs in living. And we said that some of the key features of a psychological disorder are a significant amount of distress and an impairment in everyday functioning. In class, we covered a range of psychological disorders, and I'm not going to cover most of them in this video, but I will call your attention to a couple of anxiety disorders and a couple of mood disorders that are important to be familiar with. Let's go ahead and get started with anxiety disorders. Anxiety disorders as a category are characterized, as the term implies, by the experience of anxiety, which could be fears, worry thoughts, a sense of overwhelming terror, you know, intense fear in some cases. There is also very often some level of autonomic nervous system arousal. And the autonomic nervous system arousal is not going to sound new to you because we have covered it in the context of a couple of chapters by now. And as you may remember, the anxiety response is accompanied by a sense of increased heart rate, heart palpitations, sweating, dizziness, etc. And we see some of these physiological features accompanying a number of different anxiety disorders. I'd like to talk more about panic disorder and a generalized anxiety disorder and call your attention to some of the distinguishing features between these two. Panic disorder, as you may remember, is characterized by panic attacks. It's basically a state of very intense level of anxiety that lasts a short period of time. The fear is very intense. The psychological experience is very intense. It gives you sort of a sense of terror, like I am going to die, I'm going to have a heart attack. The physiological symptoms are often fairly intense. The heart rate increases rapidly. There's a sense of sweating. There's sometimes dizziness, a sense of I may faint, I need to hold on to something. And so it can be a very distressing type of disorder that can last, the episodes can last only a brief amount of time, but they can be recurrent and a person can become scared of reliving these episodes, and that causes additional distress. So if you look at this picture and you think of a panic attack as happening, within a certain period of time and that being of a certain intensity, on the intensity scale, it's very clear that it's very high, right? It jumps up. It's a very sudden onset. The intensity level is very high. That's why it's so overwhelming and sometimes very difficult to tolerate. And then it goes down. It's very short-lived. It can last, a half an hour, often less than that. And then at some point, the anxiety level goes back to the baseline, to what it was before. Generalized anxiety disorder is very distressing as well, but unlike panic disorder, it is characterized by more of a moderate intensity anxiety that lasts a long period of time. So with generalized anxiety disorder, you don't get spikes. You get a fairly steady, maybe small ups and downs, but fairly steady level of moderate intensity anxiety that lasts usually most of the day, a lot of days in a row, etc. And it's often accompanied by a lot of worry thoughts about a lot of different things, hence the term generalized. People worry about money, about their family, about their work, about their health, and other different things. So again, this would be some of the things you may want to do when you're studying anxiety disorders. Think about sort of what are the key anxiety components and what is the intensity and how long lasting is it? Sort of just think about the different distinguishing features that will help you understand the differences between the different types of anxiety disorders. Okay, we're going to move on and briefly talk about mood disorders. Mood disorders, again, as the term implies, are associated with a disturbance in mood. Mood as a state, as an emotional state that lasts extended periods of time. I'd like to talk about depression, depressive disorder, and a bipolar disorder. A depressive disorder is characterized by episodes of depression. And as the term implies, it involves depressed, sad, or empty mood, and very often a loss of interest in the activities that a person used to enjoy doing. And there are a number of other associated signs and symptoms that include disturbance in appetite, disturbance in sleep. Again, it can go both ways. A person can sleep long, long hours or have insomnia and be unable to sleep. There's also a sense of lethargy, difficulty kind of getting up and getting going. There is often a sense of worthlessness and guilt. And some of the more worrisome features include suicidal ideation. We will talk about the treatment of disorders, including depression, in the next chapter. So I'm going to move on and just talk about some of the defining characteristics of bipolar illness next. So there's a depressive disorder, which we just discussed, and then there is a bipolar disorder. And the bipolar disorder is also characterized by episodes of depression that a lot of the times look like the depression that we would see in someone who has a depressive disorder. However, in a bipolar illness, the person also experiences episodes of mania. That's why bipolar illness is sometimes called manic depressive disorder. And the episodes of mania are associated with elevated, agitated mood, kind of being on the go, having a lot of energy, kind of restless, agitated energy, having racing thoughts, not needing a lot of sleep. That's often a key characteristic of bipolar illness. There's also a poor judgment that's very prominent for someone who is in a manic episode. People can spend a lot of money without thinking about the consequences, etc. And as depression, actually even more so than depression, bipolar illness is associated with a fairly high risk for suicide. So suicidal ideation, suicidal impulses are fairly common in someone with bipolar illness and need to be attended to and managed carefully. So again, when you're thinking about the distinction between a depressive disorder and bipolar disorder, you want to think they both have one type of episode, and that is depressive episode. The bipolar illness, in addition to that, also has episodes of mania. I'm going to pause here, and I will see you next time with a lot